Xin mời chơi những cô chú.
The President, please be seated.
Ông chủ nhiệm rẻ, bác cả, bọn tò, cách đồng nào càng
để dự thi sau nào càng
đánh đau.
Nous reprenons l'audience.
The topic today is still the implementation of the CPK's policy at S21.
Aujourd'hui, il est encore question de l'application, la mise en œuvre de la politique du PCK à S21.
The greffier is please verify
greffier,
the
veuillez.
Attendance of the parties to the proceedings today. The greffier. Mr. President, the parties to the proceedings today are all present.
Sont toutes présentes aujourd'hui. Le président.
The security personnel, please bring
the accused d'amener l'accusé à la barre.
Một lần đồng đà cà.
Before we start the session, the chamber would like to remind the parties to the proceedings.
Rappelle aux parties.
That the observation of the chamber concerning the previous questionings and with regard to the request by the interpreters, we would like the parties to speak rather slowly so that the interpreters can fully interpret
de façon à permettre une interprétation
the speech
fluide
for the good record. Also, especially when it comes to the technicalities and the legal terms used, they are advised to speak slowly. And the parties who would wish to present any documents in the court are advised to be prepared and also be ready to give the reference numbers in three languages if available.
Des documents dans les trois langues, si ces documents existent
so
dans les trois langues.
The documents can be well verified, examined before the
de
debate.
Sorte qu'ils être
it will help
contradictoirement
save our time
de ces documents.
Also, the chamber would like to also remind that when the questions are put, the questions shall be summarized and precise. So
Je vous
that
demande
the accused is able to understand them and be able to respond to such questions properly.
De sorte que celui-ci puisse répondre
also,
comme il convient.
Please be reminded that questions that are repeated and out of the facts at issue are not recommended.
Je vous demande aussi d'éviter de répéter des questions déjà posées.
The chamber
ou de poser des questions
hopes
hors
that
propos.
The parties to the proceedings will do their best to proceed
appliqueront
with
ces consignes
the questions
au
more
mieux
expeditiously.
Dans les questions qu'ils poseront dorénavant.
Now the chamber would like to give the floor to the civil party lawyers for group 3 if they would wish to put questions to the accused concerning the fact at issue.
Les faits the floor is yours. Relatifs au sujet dont nous traitons aujourd'hui.
Mr. Kim-Min-Ki, thank you, Mr. President.
Maître Kim Your Honours. Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Madame,
Judges
Monsieur le
Juge. Judges of the trial chamber and the court. After observed the questionings put to the accused, I have now got some questions to put to the accused too regarding his profession or his occupation as the educator, political educator at S21 and also the educator during the entire regime.
Et en tant My question is toute la durée
the
du régime.
General policy of the CPK that
du PCK
was applied across the country, in your opinion, was such a policy based on any socialist country or whether this is just a unique improvised policy employed by the Khmer Rouge regime itself. And I would like to also know whether the policy applied at S21 was initiated by the Khmer Rouge leaders by themselves, or was the policy influenced by the other security offices across Cambodia or from the other countries around the world.
Au Cambodge ou à l'étranger.
The accused. Réponse. Mr. Kim-min-ki's questions are rather long. I would like him to divide the questions in shorter versions.
Et j'aimerais qu'elle soit reformulée
the accused,
en segments
Mr. Kim-min-ki, I would like now to put it this way. First,
je la reformule de cette façon.
My question is, in your own opinion,
question, à votre avis,
the general policy of the CPK that was applied across the country, which was it based, from which source was this policy based?
De quelle source?
The accused. Thank you, Mr. Min-ki and Mr. President.
Merci,
I
maître.
Already stated before the chamber earlier that the Pol Potist theory of policy was used and not Marxist. Pol Pot did not follow Mao Zedong's policy. Pol Pot applied the four cliques of the China Revolution and blended in the situation in Cambodia, as you already found in the statute of the CPK. There was a stance which is about the implementation of the Leninist policy or theory as the
camp,
as the direction and as the guidance.
Comme ligne directrice.
Mr. Min-ki, do I understand correctly that the implementation of the policy of the CPK was not based entirely from other countries in the world theories, but it was it derived from its own political revolutionary theory
de sa propre théorie révolutionnaire. Réponse.
All issues had its precedence and
toutes les questions abordées avaient
post events. For example, the Pol Pot based their policy on the four group of people in China. And I believe that maybe you have not been familiar with the four cliques. These four people conducted a great cultural revolution in China. And
sur les idées de la bande des quatre,
Wang,
la bande des quatre était à l'origine de la révolution culturelle en Chine.
The accused, could you please read the names rather slowly, especially the Chinese names, so that the interpreter can render the service properly? The world knows them very well. In the dictionary, the four men clique.
Très connu de par le monde. Il s'agit de quatre personnes Wang qui composaient la bande
I don't know how it was spelled.
Je ne sais pas comment c'est la sortographie.
I cannot spell his name. Wang Hongwen, number one.
Wang Hongwen.
The deputy director of Communist Party of China, number two, Chang Chun-chiao.
Communiste chinois, ensuite Chang Chun-chiao.
Three.
Troisièmement,
Yao Wen-yen.
Yao Wai-yen.
Four.
Et quatrièmement,
Qing Qing, female
Qing Qing,
widow, the third wife of Mao Zedong. So these four men clique. After the death of Mao Zedong, they were arrested and detained.
Qui ont été arrêtés après le décès de
Mao Zedong. Based on his theory on this four men clique policy and also with his initiative, but this is only based on my observation.
Mais ça, cela c'est quelque chose que j'ai pu observer.
It was not entirely based on the Leninist and Marxist theory at that time.
Politique ne s'inspire donc pas uniquement de la pensée marxiste-léniniste.
Thank you, Mr. Menke. I would like to ask another
Merci
question concerning the S21 security office and other security offices in other revolutionary countries.
Dans
the question is,
ce genre de révolution.
The policy applied at S21, was it based on the policy from the improvised policy by Pol Pot, or was it taken after another the policy from other securities offices across the world?
Dans
the accused, I think it's really
monde.
Difficult to respond
réponse.
To such a question. The leaders talked with me several times during the work at M13. Brother Won
Wei,
the secretary of the special zone, advised me to work my best because there would never be any country who could teach us. Because if they taught us, then they would be implicated and their secrecy would be compromised. That's why he advised me to work on with our own initiatives. And he advised me to closely. And each month, I went from Ong Liang to meet him at
Rasmat.
When I came to Phnom Penh, I would like to be brief anyway. I told my superior, Son Sen, that in France there was an intelligence organization named the accused in French.
Contre-espionnage.
Il y avait des services de renseignement et de contre-espionnage.
After I reported to him, then Son Sen said that S21 should be conducted in the manner of the French intelligence organization. It means the
Français.
The ministry. And as I already mentioned earlier yesterday to Alain Werner, my superior was very meticulous at his work, and he followed up my work every evening. Sorry, I should not say every evening, almost
soir,
every evening,
pas chaque soir, peut-être
by
presque
telephone.
Chaque soir, par téléphone.
He advised me to report on my daily work. He advised me to learn to analyze and to direct me on my work.
Je lui rendais compte directement
that is the work that I used to do, and which countries that I practice, I cannot say because there is no real documentation or nobody advised me concretely on that matter. But if you talk about absolute proletarian class towards the enemy, that is clear.
Nous savions exactement qui était l'ennemi. Nous devions mener la lutte pour le
prolétariat
et défendre de façon constante et ferme la révolution. Voilà quelle était la théorie de Pol Pot. Maître Kim
Min Kin,
merci. Voici ma question suivante.
It is also related to the question that I used to ask you. And that you would answer the question when the fact related to that question arises. The question is, what is the principle of the CPK party in identification the enemy?
Comment
and what does
PCK
it mean? And what does the term enemy mean? The accused. The word enemy, if we talk in terms of analyzing the Cambodian society
dans le contexte de la société
before the 17th April,
avant le 17 avril,
the analyst on the classes, they would clarify the classes into the peasant and workers class.
Il y avait la classe des paysans et des travailleurs.
The petty bourgeoisie class, including the intellectuals in that class.
Les intellectuels.
The capitalist.
Il y avait les capitalistes.
Nationalist class, and then the two reactionaries class.
Et les nationalistes.
The capitalist and the reactionary class.
Ainsi que les réactionnaires.
In 1974,
the
revolutionary flag determines the two special classes of the society.
That is, au sein de la société.
The soldier and the police class, that's one special class, and another
d'une
special
part,
class
les soldats et la police.
That is determined by Pol Pot, that is the Buddhist monks in the religion.
Le clergé bouddhiste.
Let me clarify on these two special classes.
Deux classes spéciales définies par le drapeau révolutionnaire.
There is no document.
Je m'explique. Il n'y a pas de document.
The Communist Party document is not as same as the Pol Pot Communist document.
Et maintenant,
regarding these two classes,
Parti communiste
when we talk about
the
monarchy,
classes, il s'agit
the
là de quelque chose
Chinese
Pol
Communist Party. The Chinese Communist Party document is also different from the CPK document.
Défini les classes de manière
différente. And when we
talk
about these two special classes, that is the,
ici, nous avions deux
the soldier and the police class and the Buddhist monks class,
Pol Pot
designated that for the Buddhist religion in Cambodia,
a dit que pour le clergé bouddhiste,
it is acceptable. But the bad thing is about the belief in the sin.
On pouvait les accepter.
And for the monks, the monks are the children of the peasants.
Il fallait combattre la croyance en la religion.
And their livelihood depends on the peasants. If the peasants
plus,
do not provide food to the monks, then the monks would not exist.
De la population.
So here
sans
is the theory about the religions and the monks.
Les moines pouvaient survivre.
And when he talked about the police and the soldiers,
pour ce qui est de la police et des soldats,
hold the enemy's weapons and kill the Cambodian people. That was in 1974, and that was the document that I saw. And in the 17th April, the surviving documents showed that the other classes had been eradicated.
Il apparaît que
and
les
only these
autres
two classes were formed.
Supprimées.
So the evacuation is also based on these classes.
Classes.
Only the two classes remains, that is the peasant and the workers classes.
Mais après la révolution, il ne devait subsister que les deux classes authentiques, à savoir les ouvriers et
the
les paysans.
Eradication of the capitalist, then the state would control the factories. That's because of the class.
Contrôler les
the
usines.
Intellectuals were evacuated to the countryside
les
to do farming.
Eux ont été and évacués some à la campagne were pour smashed, faire des travaux
and
de
some even
certains
were
ont
sent
été
to
éliminés.
S21.
Certains
it's
ont même
of the class.
À cause de leur appartenance de classe.
That is the first stage before the document dated the 30 of March 1976.
C'est là la première étape qui précède le document du 30 mars 1976.
And because the Cambodian Revolution only had two special classes. Then I presume that the Pol Pot theory is not the same as the Mao theory. The Maoist theory
de Pol Pot n'est pas absolument similaire à la politique de Mao.
Liberation, he had four classes in his country. That is, the workers class,
à savoir les travailleurs,
the peasants class,
les paysans,
the petty bourgeoisie class, including the intellectuals,
y compris les
intellectuels, and then the capitalist nationalist class.
La classe capitaliste nationaliste.
Built or designed small four flags, small four stars on the flag to represent those four classes.
Drapeau, quatre étoiles qui
and
représentent
the big star
classes.
Represents the Chinese Communist Party.
La grande étoile représente le Parti communiste chinois.
That is an evidence, and another evidence is.
Autre
about
preuve,
the flags of the Democratic Cambodia,
le
Angkor
Wat
only had three temples, and Prince Sihanouk also had the flag with three temples of the Angkor Wat, and the middle one
trois tours d'Angkor Wat,
represents the party, although there is no documentation on
la
that,
tour du milieu représente
and
le parti
the two
communiste,
other temples represents
couvent,
the peasants' class and the workers' class.
Des paysans et la classe
if
des
you
travailleurs.
To the national,
si vous écoutez
national rhythm, then it talks about the blood of the peasants and the workers' class, the youth's blood, and also talks about the blood of the workers, the peasants, the combattants, and the revolutionary youth.
Ainsi
and the rest of the class were not mentioned.
Les autres classes ne sont pas mentionnées dans l'hymne national.
So Mao Zedong kept four classes and Pol Pot only kept two classes.
Et, Pol Pot, lui, n'en a
so,
que
based
deux.
On this analysis, the Pol Pot theory or doctrine is not the same as the Maoist theory.
Pol Pot n'est pas la même que la doctrine
this is another
de Mao.
Principle when we talk about the foundation of the political
c'est
doctrine.
À souligner lorsque l'on parle des
this is my response
de la doctrine
to the question. I am not sure whether I answered to
je ne suis pas sûr,
your question correctly
d'y avoir,
or not.
Répondu tout à fait correctement.
Some key main key. Let me clarify further
permettez-moi de vous demander
on the matter.
Détailler sur cette question.
When you talk about the enemy,
détailler cette question au point
the enemy
lorsque vous parlez de
in 1974 was about the classes, including the Buddhist monks, the police, and the soldiers.
Police,
and after the 17 April, it talks about the capitalists.
Après le 17 avril, on parle des capitalistes.
But after the decision,
mais après la décision
made on the 30 of March 1976, the classes remained in only two forms, and the rest were regarded as enemies. Is that correct?
Considérés comme des ennemis. Est-ce
the accused.
Exact?
Thank you for this further clarification. I think I wandered in the wrong direction. Actually, in 1974, there was a document
direction après
about the special classes, but he did not do any thing on
des
that.
Classes spéciales,
he only educated people on the party's lines and policies. And only after the 17th April 75, he started to show those classes.
Et après
as I said earlier, the 17th April,
en avant
he depended
ces classes.
His
comme je l'ai dit, après
strengths on the cadres within the army.
Au sein de l'armée.
So that is the reality. So the evacuation, like I just said,
comme je viens de
is
dire,
based on the screening and the purchase of those classes.
La sélection et la purge
only the two classes remained after the 17th April, that is the peasant class and the workers class.
À savoir la classe paysanne et la classe des travailleurs.
And actually it's called collective peasants class and collective workers class because there are mobile units, SWAT teams, groups, and mobile brigades, etc.
Et des brigades mobiles ainsi que des groupes mobiles.
So it is called collective peasants class and collective workers class throughout the country. All the units were organized properly into these two separate classes.
Toutes les personnes étaient donc
so the enemy had been eradicated.
Entre ces deux classes ou tombées, faisaient partie de ces deux catégories.
Know,
les autres classes étaient éradiquées. Et à ma connaissance,
the patriarch would that because of his well-known work and achievement.
Étant donné,
this is from what I know, there is no documentation to show that.
Connu, que je
the General Ding Nai-yong and
Ding
the General Chum Chun and Chia Kim Ain were within the hands.
Était, la d'abresse excuse, mais n'a pas entendu l'ensemble des noms.
They were within the hands of the 703, so they tried to get rid of the patriarch, and all the novice monks were evacuated to the countryside, and they were forced to do farming. So there were various goals, objectives in achieving the direction in order to reform them to become either peasant or workers class, and if anyone opposed, he or she would be arrested.
Paysans, membres de la classe paysanne.
So
si
most people would not oppose, but the, the intellectuals would be sought out from the countryside.
Donc,
and the document dated the 30th March 76,
Pol Pot
talked about the inside party, as I reported to the co-investigating judges. That was the time when he tried to seek out the enemy infiltrated within the party.
À éliminer l'ennemi à l'intérieur du parti, infiltré dans le parti.
So this is my clarification. When we talk about the general line on who is regarded as enemy,
générale,
however, in actual practice, how can we determine someone to be an enemy? So then it comes toward those four groups of people as designated in the decision dated the 30th of March 76.
Eh bien, c'est la décision
those four groups would make the decision.
Qui désigne
there was a general line, but in practice, only one of those four groups
ennemis.
Would make decisions. For example,
générales,
within the army
pratique,
of the center, only one person could make a decision, that is my superior, Sun Sen. Besides him, nobody dared to make a decision. Otherwise, the person would be beheaded.
De lui,
so that is in practice.
Personne n'osait prendre les décisions. Donc, voici la théorie et voici la
so,
pratique.
And it was based on the decision of those four
ceci
groups.
Était sur la base de la décision prise par des personnes appartenant
Kim and Kim.
À l'un
thank
de
you.
Ces quatre groupes. Maître Kim and Kim.
In relation to what you have said, there are two stages in smashing the enemy. The first one, the first phase is from the 17th April, and the second phase started after the decision of the 30th of March 76. So I have one question to ask you. Can you provide explanation? What is the purpose of the developments and change? To the meaning of smashing the enemy within the CPK policy.
Sens du terme écraser l'ennemi dans le cadre de la politique du PCK.
The accused. Let me recall a slogan.
Permettez-moi de citer un slogan.
It is a slogan of the Communist Party of Cambodia.
PCK,
it says our victory is.
Notre victoire
the victory of the masses.
La victoire des masses.
That is the great masses,
à savoir
the great movement, the great masses, the great leap forward,
les grandes masses, le grand bond en avant.
So when all those various classes were eliminated, only two classes remained, that was called the great victory. So if you look at the main goal of communism, what is it? The main goal of the communism is to have only one class, that is the workers' class. The socialist society is based on the social, on the workers' class. However, in Cambodia, there were two classes at the time, the peasants' class and the workers' class. And another point of view, there is also a slogan in the socialist society,
that is, société socialiste, qui est le suivant.
Everybody strives their best,
tout le monde essaie
and
de faire
to
son
get
mieux
the result based on their needs.
Obtenir des résultats
and in the
en
communist
de
society,
des besoins.
Et the slogan is,
communiste,
everyone tries their best,
tout le monde
and
essaie de faire de son mieux,
they get based on what they need, not what they want.
Ils obtiennent non pas ce
for example,
qu'ils veulent,
I try to work for them,
ce qu'elles veulent, mais ce dont
and
elles
I have
besoin.
The same food as the rest.
Par exemple, moi, je mange la même
especially for the combatant, they only had one soup or one food for them. But for me, I would have two dishes
soupe,
because I like dry food.
Pour eux.
And then I would have my special ration, that is,
moi,
I would have the cigarettes, the motorbike.
Donc, ma ration spéciale, j'avais
that's based on the need for to fulfill my duty,
besoins,
to serve the revolution.
De me permettre
and there is
de
the need.
M'acquitter de mes devoirs, de
so
mes obligations.
That's the ultimate objective.
Donc, ceci est l'objectif.
However, in actual practice, from what I can recall, I think that is the question posed by
Senarong,
the co-prosecutor. It talks about the staff of the people, the starvation of the people.
Parle,
so when the revolutionist people went there, they had plenty of food. And I told him that it was only the theory that was to get rid of their cliques, their opponents, and put the people from their side. And Pol Pot only trusted the Tamok's clique, and he did not trust other people's teams. For example, people from the north zone, they tried in the revolution, but in the end, on the 31st of January 77, there were mass arrests of those people, and they were brought to S21. Those north zone cadres had emotional feeling towards myself, because I knew them and I was shocked too at the time.
Ces cadres et moi, on avait
I
une
thought
relation,
those people who sacrificed their lives, their flesh and blood for the revolution, the party, and now they come and die at S21, and it's speechless for me.
Qui s'étaient consacrés à la révolution ont échoué
so
à S21
the secret is, Pol Pot only trusted the peasants from Tamok's side and not the other teams.
Dans
so
les
this is the category that I would draw for the chamber to
dans
consider.
Les rangs de Tamok, hein, et pas, ils n'avaient pas confiance dans les autres. Donc voilà, c'est ce que je souhaitais présenter devant la chambre.
Lawyer Ki Ming Ki, I now understand something about the purpose of the revolution based on the theory, as what you mentioned, that they only wanted to leave one or two classes in the society for the revolutionary society, and the other classes had to be gotten rid of. But in practice, there was an internal conflict in the communist party. So what do you think about this? Was there any conflict?
Qu'en pensez-vous?
The accused, actually, basically, it is correct.
Effectivement, c'est vrai.
Kiminki, I would like to ask another question regarding the internal conflict in the CPK.
au sein du PCK.
And the purpose of smashing the enemies was it initiated by the senior leaders to get rid of those internal enemies, and by way of smashing such enemies, what means was used to apply such to smash those people, or was there any mechanism or other people from other ministries were d'autres mécanismes, really, est-ce que d'autres personnes venant des ministères étaient
instruites en juin de accomplir ces tâches?
L'institution qui déterminait
qui était les l'institution suprême était le comité permanent du parti.
And it was obviously Brother Paul, the secretary of the party, because he issued the political the party's line, and he also controlled the education. He appointed people. You can refer to the remaining documents on the 19th, on the 20th, on the 21st of April. He appointed about 13 institutions, and he appointed almost everything. The document on the 9th of October 1975, he appointed Son Sen as a police. So we can still refer to the documents, and it is easy to prove it.
Au document, il est facile de prouver cela.
Mr. Kimenki, I would like to move back to the question concerning the implementation of policy at S21 regarding the smashing of the enemies. The question is, did S21 implement the policy of the CPK determined by the four groups, or was that was the policy decided only by one unique group among the four?
A-t-elle été décidée par un seul de ces quatre groupes?
These four groups of people comprised of 14 people, but only one of them took control of S21. It was Son Sen. Not all the 14 people took control of S21 altogether.
Ne contrôlait pas S21 de manière collégiale.
Kimenki, I may ask another question. So you were supervised directly by Son Sen. So under his supervision and orders, was there any factual principle or policy to smash enemies applied at S21? Was there any strategic plan, for example, the three-year strategic plan for smashing enemies at S21?
L'écrasement des ennemis à S21.
Comme son numéro. The accused. I confess that such plan never existed. I never saw it.
N'a jamais existé.
It's real that I never saw it.
Vérité dans les faits.
The roles of S21 was to interrogate people who were arrested and sent to it. After confessions were taken, then they were sent to the upper echelon, and then S21 had to take them out to be smashed. Otherwise, if, for example, the confessions were not satisfied, then we had to extract further confessions. And S21 had no authority to release anyone. Otherwise, we would be in big trouble. And we had no right to decide to arrest anyone. But when someone was arrested, then we had to actually smash them.
Mais lorsque quelqu'un était arrêté, eh bien, nous devions procéder à l'écrasement.
Pierre Pointe. Kimenki.
Maître Kimenki.
You said that there was no actual plan, but there was, of course, the transfer of people, the prisoners to S21 to be interrogated, to extract confessions. So in such extractions of confessions, were there any methods used to extract exact or particular confessions they S21 would like to get, or would there be any just random extraction of confessions without any particular
purpose in that? D'aveu plus
the accused.
Aléatoire, entre
the method of interrogating
au hasard.
The prisoners.
Travail systématique.
Although tortures were subjected to support such techniques, people were not really beating right away in the right place at the beginning. We employed modest torturing techniques at the beginning, and then it intensified accordingly. For example, Pons had the ability to analyze the prisoners, and he did not resort to tortures immediately like Brother Mornay did. Other people were quick to torture the prisoners like Comrade Doi. So, in conclusion, the confessions at S21 were mainly based on tortures, except Khoi Thun, who was never been beaten.
À l'exception de Khoi Thun, qui n'a jamais été passé à tabac.
Even I myself did not dare analyze his confession, so I had to transfer the confession exclusively to the superior without analyzing it because it was beyond my capacity to do so. So I only did my best to make sure that I can liaise the readings of the confessions of my superior while they read the materials. For example, the confessions that I mentioned to Mr. Alain Wagner that I, of course, annotated internally. I only annotated to note further to the brother. For example, I would say, brother, this guy had a connection with Cam Hang Rut, for example, and I remembered that I did annotate such a note. And sometimes I made annotations, sometimes I did not dare do it. For example, regarding the document the Kimberley brought circulated across the country, I think I did very little to annotate on that piece of document. Maybe I did not even annotate at all. So these annotations are only for my superior to be able to easily read the materials and grasp the concept more quickly. And I did not, I did not really change the objectivity of the document itself. So the confessions were extracted, but I did not subjectively annotate on those annotations. And when I interrogated myself, when I interrogated Khoi Thun, I did not even come to the point straightforward because Khoi Thun was quick to react. And sometimes he even broke the glasses or the pen, so I let him calm down for half an hour before I started to interrogate him. And when he met me, I smiled to him and I said to him, brother, why did you do that? Do not think that I am fooled by way of your anger, and I would beat you to death until the confession was cut off. I was not stupid to do that. And I already promised that if you wrote anything in the confession, I would be serving as your messenger to transfer this confession to the party. So you had no other alternative to send your confession to the party except through me. So after all, he was convinced. So I think in interrogating, I educated my colleagues not to be so subjectively in pressing, putting pressure on the confession. And at M13, regarding the beating of a female detainee, we tried to find a way to get out of the main focus, and we made her have a bath and then exposed to the cold wind. So the technique in interrogating people were advised not to be subjectively to press a detainee to give the confession. When interrogating, although tortures were subject to be applied as the support tools, some other people resorted to use the torturing techniques immediately. That's why I told you already that there were tortures, some cruel tortures, and some were not really cruel. But I do accept all the responsibility of all kinds of tortures employed at S21. But when it comes to the documents, I did the annotation, but it was in the purpose for facilitating the smooth reading of the document, but I did not really subjectively annotated on any particular document. I was not biased. And I would like to reiterate that documents at S21, when they were left, they were transferred directly to Son Sen through the organizational communication structure, the vertical line of communication between I and Son Sen. And then the documents would be transferred further to Angkor Noon or Pol Pot. Then the documents would be circulated to the zones. So the central party were not entitled to just receive all the documents and make any annotation they would wish to do so like that.
Personne ne pouvait porter des annotations comme cela à ces documents s'il souhaitait le faire. Il y avait Kimenki, une thank méthode.
So,
Maître Kimenki,
you are saying that and previously that regarding the terms enemies who were sent to S21 were regarded as dead already. Or if they were regarded as enemies,
mort,
they were perceived to have
mort,
been smashed already.
So, comme ayant déjà été
in annotating on any particular on confessions regarding those who were sent, why should you annotate on such confessions because those people were somehow regarded as dead people already?
Personne n'était déjà considéré comme étant morte.
The accused. Thank you, Mr. Menke.
L'accusé. Merci, maître.
For raising this matter. The people who were arrested and sent, they were all dead.
Et envoyés.
That is true.
Était
however,
morte.
The upper echelon needed the confessions.
Tout cependant,
in order
l'échelon supérieur
to arrest other people. So this is the second purpose of its nature.
Personnes. C'est le
the
deuxième
first
objectif
purpose is to smash people who were arrested.
Est d'écraser les personnes
number
qui
two
arrêtées.
Is to track down other people to be arrested.
Des autres personnes pour qu'elles soient arrêtées.
Hello.
The president,
le président
the defense lawyers for the civil party, do you think you have more questions to put to the accused because it has already been an hour? So could you please be precise and not repeat it, although you have avoided to be to repeat your questions, but we remind you to please ask questions that are not repeated, and the accused also advised to not respond to the repeated question, so you enjoy this right at all times.
Vous pouvez exercer ce droit et jouir de ce droit à tout instant.
Mr. Menke, thank you, Mr. President.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président.
I have a few more questions,
il nous reste quelques
but
questions
I don't
poser,
know whether the responses
si
are long.
Vont
good than expected, because it depends on the accused who may answer in short or long. I will try my best to summarize my questions as much as I can, and I will try my best not to repeat questions. If I am permitted, may I continue putting more questions to the accused before we take an adjournment, or do you think I should leave the questions after the break? The President, you can actually put more questions to the accused. The chamber only reminds you to make sure that we can expeditiously proceed further, and in ways of asking questions to the accused, we would recommend that you summarize your questions and make sure that the questions are precise so that the accused can answer straight to the point. And we just don't want to hear the repeated answers or likewise the repeated questions. Thank you, Mr. President Kim-Eng-Ki. Mr. Kang-Gek-il, the next question is about the wordings of Pol Pot, who said that the sharpened thought is the sword that is sharpened every day and used
affûté,
on a daily basis. So in your
au quotidien,
implementation of the policy to smash
épuisé
enemies, actually in
at
S21, did you prepare any particular policy in order to apply the slogan implied by Pol Pot? The accused, I would like to state that
Pol Pot, sous-entendu par Pol Pot, reprend l'interprète, l'accuse, l'interprète reprend l'accusé.
The urgent need was based on the upper echelon. In order to answer to that need and demand, we did not really shout it or put more pressure on our subordinates, but the best solution was to train them. So it's only the best option to answer to the needs of the upper echelon. Whether there was any actual plan or when people would be educated, it was not precise. We only did it according to the needs of the superiors.
Nous ne répondions qu'aux exigences de nos supérieurs.
Kim-Eng-Ki, thank you.
Kim-Eng-Ki, je vous remercie.
I have no question regarding to this topic.
Je n'ai pas d'autres questions à poser sur ce sujet.
Other questions regarding to the slogans,
je voudrais en arriver au
which
slogan
are the play of words during the time,
or
it might be the party's
Pol
policies at the time.
En rapport avec la politique.
If you're able to explain those slogans,
que vous expliquiez
I would
slogans
ask you some slogans. One is,
en voici le premier.
There is no gains to keep, there is
nous n'avons
no
rien
loss
à gagner,
to
à vous garder, et rien
dispense
à perdre, à vous éliminer.
So can you explain this slogan
est-ce
to
que
us?
Vous pouvez nous expliquer ce slogan, Khmer Rouge?
the accused.
Réponse.
The slogan, that slogan is not for entertainment. At S21, I heard all the times by
S21, c'est quelque
my
chose
superiors on
qui était très souvent répété
and
par
also
mon supérieur
the civil parties also used to say those slogans. Also in their complaints, the slogan was written.
Et le retrouve
so
aussi
this slogan was not only heard at S21, but also at the countryside.
Donc c'est quelque chose qu'on entend à S21, mais aussi partout dans le pays.
Gaming key.
Question.
What is the concrete meaning of that slogan? Can you explain?
Et qu'est-ce que ça veut dire concrètement?
The accused.
Réponse.
This is just a pretext of the standing committee.
C'est juste une façon
or
de
probably
dire
by one individual of those four groups. If we complain to them, they would say there is no gain to keep,
si
there is no loss to dispense. Yesterday
rien
I used
à vous garder,
slogan.
Rien à perdre à vous éliminer.
When I gave in, the stance of Sun Saint talk about the minors, talk about the young and old children, and actually I used
c'est
that slogan.
Quelque chose que j'ai dit aussi.
However, this is my current analysis.
Au sujet des jeunes ou des mineurs.
Whatever he said at the time, I could not recall. But I initially heard those words from him. And another slogan that I would like to ask.
Slogan. L'avocat s'interrompt.
To protest is the enemy.
Protester.
And to complain is to be killed.
C'est
the accused. I never heard that slogan, but I think it might reflect the conditions of the
l'accusé.
Situation at the time.
Je ne me souviens pas d'avoir entendu cela.
Kimenki. Next, another slogan that you
question.
Said yesterday,
un autre slogan
that is fast
hier.
Attack,
attaque rapide,
fast success.
Succès rapide.
Does it mean to smash quickly and then you
est-ce
will get a quick
qu'il
result?
Faut écraser rapidement pour
the
avoir
accused.
Des résultats rapidement?
Réponse. Let me reiterate that I use that slogan
non,
when I talk about
dit,
trying to get the opportunity to conduct a training, even if for 1 hour session.
Une formation qui durait une heure.
So it means to attack that 1 hour in order to
et
accomplish
ça,
the task in front of me. It means in this week or in the next week. So I talk in the context of the training.
Ou ce jour-là. Mais donc c'est quelque chose que je disais dans le contexte de la formation.
Let me continue
question
to my last question on the slogan.
Dernier slogan.
The word is to dig the grass is to dig its root. Is this the only this is the slogan used at
S21?
The accused. I never used this slogan to teach
slogan
my subordinates or my staff.
Je n'ai jamais utilisé ce slogan
and
dans
I haven't heard, I did not hear the slogan used
et
at S21.
Je n'ai pas entendu prononcer
so
à
I believe the slogan might have been used outside of S21.
Et sans doute a-t-il été utilisé, mais à l'extérieur de S21.
Question. Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci.
The lawyers for group for civil party group 3 have no more questions.
Monsieur le Président, le groupe 3, on a ainsi terminé avec ses questions à l'accusé sur ce sujet.
OK.
Monsieur le Président, j'ai quelques questions
President,
très rapides.
I have a few additional questions to put very briefly to the accused.
Monsieur. Pardon, monsieur, vous nous avez parlé d'une méthode d'enseignement, attaque rapide, succès rapide.
Teaching, rapid
est-ce vous qui l'avez mise au point?
Did you develop this method?
biệt này.
The accused.
Réponse.
This phrase is not my phrase.
Cette phrase n'est
it's
pas
the phrase
de mon
used by the leadership label.
Phrase utilisée au niveau de la direction.
But I cannot recall from whom I have heard or at what year or whether I have read it through the revolutionary magazine, flag magazine.
Peut-être l'ai-je lu dans le drapeau révolutionnaire, je ne me souviens pas.
Mais est-ce vous qui avez utilisé cette expression pour en faire un mode d'enseignement?
To turn it into a tool for teaching.
Très bien.
My activities and the lines that I follow in teaching is based on that
dans
slogan.
Dans la formation que je donnais, oui, je me basais sur ce slogan.
Est-ce que vous avez rendu compte de cette méthode?
Report
à vos supérieurs.
On the use of this method to your superiors.
Méthode.
The accused.
Méthine.
The methods that I use, I learned from someone else and I implemented based on someone else, so there is no need for me to report.
De quelqu'un d'autre et je n'avais pas besoin d'en rendre compte.
Est-ce qu'à votre connaissance, elle a été utilisée dans d'autres centres?
Has this method been used in other centers also?
I did not use this method elsewhere. Besides for the
je
training purpose, I'm the only one person at the S21.
Je suis le seul à avoir à l'avoir utilisé pour la formation S21.
To be responsible for the training.
Car j'étais responsable de la formation.
Excusez-moi. Combien de temps consacriez-vous à la formation
would be devoted
dans l'ensemble de vos fonctions?
To training. How much time compared to your other duties? How much time would you devote to training activities?
The accused.
La traduction anglaise n'a pas été entendue.
Mr. President, Mr. Gangayev, respond clearly to the questions because the interpreter cannot hear you.
Est-ce que l'accusé peut répéter, car les interprètes n'ont pas entendu.
You need to leave enough gap for the interpreter to interpret. The accused.
L'accusé.
Could you clarify your question clearly
question
because I could not understand your question properly?
Comprise.
Je la formule autrement. Est-ce que vos activités
way
de formation et d'éducation
like
de vos subordonnés représentaient l'essentiel de votre temps de travail
that
ou pas?
Covered, whether it occupied most of your working time or not?
The accused. At S21, I had three important duties.
À S21, j'avais trois tâches principales.
One, to teach or to train.
Un, assurer la formation.
Two,
deux,
to send the confessions to
envoyer les
my
aveux
superior.
À mes supérieurs.
Initially, I made annotations,
au
but
départ,
later on, I did not pay much attention to the annotations
ensuite,
on the confessions.
Je n'ai plus prêté beaucoup attention à cela.
And three,
et
to manage and resolve all the matters, all the issues at the S21
as I was overall in charge. Puisque j'étais chargé de diriger le centre.
Si je comprends bien,
Mrs. Robinson Ratana, if I understand
vous aviez
you correctly,
deux,
you had
deux tâches qui occupaient peut-être les deux tiers de votre temps, la formation et envoyer des aveux. Est-ce que vous pouvez nous confirmer?
And, can you confirm this?
That is correct.
Oui, c'est exact.
I agree to your suggestion.
Je suis d'accord avec ce que vous dites.
Je vous remercie.
Mrs. Robinson-Ratana, thank you, sir.
Je peux donc considérer que votre fonction était une fonction plus politique qu'une fonction technique.
Nature, more of a political than of a technical nature. Am I correct?
The accused. My duties, in fact, had more political nature than technical nature.
Était plus politique que technique.
Je vous remercie.
Thank you.
Pensiez-vous que la politique du PCK était une bonne politique pour le pays?
Were good policies for the country?
The
accused. How could we say that? It's the criminal policy.
C'était une politique criminelle.
It was the most serious criminal policies than those gang of four in China.
C'est une politique encore plus criminelle que celle de la bande des quatre en Chine.
Mrs. Robinson-Ratana.
Je vous remercie. Est-ce que vous dites ça en fonction de vos connaissances actuelles,
now,
ou est-ce que c'est ce que vous pensiez déjà à l'époque?
Was, or was that what you already believed at that time?
The accused, my current knowledge leads me to this understanding and to make me say these words.
D'après ce que je sais aujourd'hui.
At that time,
à l'époque,
my impression was that the killing was widespread,
que l'on tuait de façon généralisée.
However, I, as a policeman
mais
of the state,
en tant qu'agent de la sécurité de l'État, j'étais responsable
before both the national and international laws.
Devant les
That's
règles nationales et internationales.
Back to what I did at the time.
D'où ce que j'ai pu faire à l'époque.
Je n'ai plus de questions, Monsieur le Président.
Mrs. Robinson-Ratana, I have completed my questions. Thank you, President.
Mr. President, next. The floor is open to the lawyers for the party group 4 if you have a question to be put to the accused.
Questions à poser à l'accusé.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président.
I have some questions to be put to Mr. Kang Kek-il, alias Deutsch.
À l'accusé.
And I will try not to delay the proceedings
et j'essaierai de ne
or
pas prendre
to
trop
ask
de temps
any repetitive questions.
Ni de poser de questions qui ont déjà
Mr.
été
Mr. President, your honors.
Posé à l'accusé.
Regarding the implementation of the CPK policy at
S21,
if there are questions which are repetitive or similar in nature,
si vous pensez que
I will not try to ask those questions.
Est redondante,
but on certain areas, I am not clear, and
je
I would like clarification from Mr. Kang Kek-il, alias Deutsch.
Je suis sûr d'avoir entièrement compris, et je voudrais que l'accusé nous précise les
Yesterday,
choses.
Yesterday, you
Hier,
told the president and the chamber
au président, il y a la chambre,
regarding the meetings or the trainings or the education.
Ce qu'il en était des ces séances de formation
of the staff or cadre
organisées
at
pour
the
le personnel
S21
ou les de S21.
You also told the chamber that you paid serious attention to
et vous avez dit prêter une grande attention
the use or the implementation of the CPK
à la mise en
statute. If I am not mistaken,
PCK,
that is what
si
you said.
Compris.
Am I correct?
Est-ce que je me trompe?
The accused. That was
réponse.
What I said.
Oui, c'est bien ce que j'ai dit.
Hong Kong Soon, thank you.
Question, merci.
Besides the CPK statute
en dehors des
of the Democratic
PCK,
of Cambodia, there are Revolutionary Flag magazines and the youth magazines,
la revue
and the letters or decisions
jeunesse,
of the central or the standing committees on a number of issues, as you repeatedly said, that is the decision of the 30th
March
1976. Are there any other documents
y d'autres
of the standing committees which were issued and that you studied
que vous auriez étudié.
The accused.
Réponse.
Thank you, Mr. Kum Soon, for raising this matter. I would like to state that
merci de poser cette question.
At that time,
je voudrais
there were only documents,
qu'à l'époque,
that is the core documents, the CPK statute,
on avait que les documents de
and
base,
the Revolutionary Flag magazines
donc,
and the youth
statuts,
magazines, they are the documents to be used internally
jeunes,
inside the party, but they are not the fundamental
interne.
Document
du parti.
And the DK constitution, as I told the honors, it is a facade
et comme j'ai déjà
as a
dit,
decoration of the activities.
Elle était plutôt une façade.
And as a middle cadre or the full rise member
les membres
at the time,
du parti,
I did not see
ou les cadres
any other decisions of the standing committee, including the decision dated 30 March 1976. I only saw this decision at the ECCC when the co-investigating judges presented it to me for me to analyze and to respond to their questions. As for the decision on the 9th October 75, I only saw it during the hearing.
Je n'en ai eu connaissance qu'à l'audience.
I only saw it here,
ici,
at the ECCC.
Au CETC.
So, to conclude, the fundamental document
donc,
for my
base,
study and to protect my life is the CPK statute. That is my response to you. Mr. Hong Kong Soon, thank you.
Question, merci.
My next question.
Question suivante.
Your training or your education for the staff and your subordinates at the S21 office.
Vous dispensez une formation à votre
yesterday
personnel,
you
à vos
told the chamber
à S21. Hier, vous avez dit à la chambre
about the meetings or the trainings.
Qu'il y avait
although there's a group of four or five, you
séances,
would open the training or the meeting
cinq, hein,
at a location where you use a microphone to speak to those people.
Où vous utilisiez un micro.
Is such a regular education or training? Here I don't mean about the taking the opportunity. Is such training focused on which matter, which core matter?
Employer des méthodes précises. Quelle était la méthode?
The accused. I think
réponse.
I have already answered.
Je crois
I would like to leave the floor open for you to analyze my previous answer. I'm sorry, I will not answer anymore regarding that matter. Mr. Hong Kong Soon, thank you.
Maître
just
Hong
now,
Kusun,
you
merci.
Told the court about the 14 people, and you said that only Son Sen who
hier,
had
vous avez dit que seul
the
Son Sen
power
avait
over S21.
Une autorité sur S21.
Since I want everyone to hear this, and there has been several Khmer expressions concerning the word Angkan, the central party,
le parti, le central du parti, committee, le comité central,
the standing committee,
le comité permanent.
Were these words the same,
or si
was the power of this group of people the same or different?
S'il s'agit toujours du même groupe de personnes ou de gens différents.
Thank you.
Réponse.
I would like to confirm this matter in a more clarified means. Again.
Oui, je peux the clarifier les choses.
Central committee had four levels.
Central,
the lowest
were niveaux.
The assistant to the center.
Il y avait les assistants du centre,
these
ça, les
people had the right to
de gens qui
attend
le droit
study
de
sessions with other people, but during the general meeting of the center, they did not have any rights to make any comments.
Ils ne pouvaient pas intervenir.
Before I come to the point number two, I would like to elaborate further on this. People who were classified in the assistant to the center first was Chum Sam Auk, alias Bang, and Su Med and Mia Mot, also included in. I cannot grasp how many people there were.
Je ne peux pas vous dire combien de personnes.
Above them,
il y avait,
there were
à l'échelon
candidate
juste
members
on trouvait
of the
les
center.
Membres suppléants du centre.
They had significant authority, for example, during the general meeting. They attended the meeting and they had the rights to make comments. So they had these two exclusive rights. The candidate members whom I know was Brother 81, the deputy secretary of the general staff.
De l'état-major était dans ce cas.
Above them, the full tri members of the center, these people had the right to attend study sessions, had the right to make comments in those sessions, and had the right to vote and make any decision on any kind of political line. I would like to raise a few members of the full tri members who died. Brother Bok, the secretary of the North Zone, who was one of the full tri members of the center. Khoi Thun also was the full tri member.
Khoi Thun était aussi membre de plein droit, membre titulaire.
Above them, it was the standing committee.
Il y avait le comité permanent.
From one meeting to another, the person who was in charge of implementing such policies was the standing committee. They had the authority, the right to decide on any matter decided by the general meeting. And in that standing committee, my superior was the seventh person, while Pol Pot was number one person. Mr. Hong Kum Soon, thank you. Just now,
merci.
You stated about the center or the standing committee.
Vous venez de parler du centre ou comité permanent.
The accused. I did not finish my
excusez,
responses regarding the term
Angkan
yet. For S21, the people who represented the standing committee who led S21 was called Angkan. Even Son Sen was called Angkan. Son Sen even addressed Brother Paul as Angkan.
Et Son Sen parlait
and
de
I even
Pol Pot
called
en
him as Angkan.
Et moi-même je l'ai désigné aussi en disant l'Angkar.
Thank you, said Mr. Hong Kim-soon. In Mr. your role,
merci.
Before you were appointed as the chief of S21,
avant que vous ne soyez désigné
in your previous statements, you said you had study sessions with Sun Sen at the train station,
il y a déjà
with
eu des séances in Lon, alias Nan.
Was that, is that correct?
Nat. Est-ce exact?
The accused, no, it's not correct.
Réponse, non, c'est faux.
I stayed at the train station and
logé
my superior asked me to work at that location. I did not attend study session.
Mais je ne participais pas à des
about 15 minutes only to discuss about the establishment of S21. It was only about the presentation of how S21 would be established.
Mr. Hong Kim-soon, thank you. Merci.
Regarding the arrangements and the initiation of the establishment of S21, according to your statement, the decision were made from the standing committee member. So Sun Sen asked you to meet him about 15 minutes, as you said. It was Sun Sen's idea to introduce you to that concept, or it was the decision by the standing committee as a whole?
Dans son ensemble.
The accused.
Réponse.
I would like to clarify it. I would like to make comments on what you have understood so far. I think you are still confused regarding what the central party is. When Sun Sen asked me and Nat to meet him, I believe that it was from the decision by Brother Paul, the highest person of the party. So it was from the secretary of the party's
decision.
Mr. Kim-soon, thank you.
Maître Hong Kim-soon, je vous remercie.
At S21, after Nat,
the
predecessor before you, and you took charge, later on,
Nat a d'abord été le
yesterday
directeur,
you
vous.
Mentioned the person named Hoi.
Hier, vous avez mentionné
I'm not sure whether
Hoi.
He was Hoi Srei or Hum Hoi. Could you please clarify
Hoi
it?
Or the, Hoi Srei?
The accused. Thank
Réponse.
You for asking that question. Comrade Hum Hoi,
il s'agit de Hum
at that time,
Hum Hoi.
Was still in the company, but Hoi Srei was in the company with me. His name was Nun Hoi.
À l'époque était ailleurs. Il s'agit de Hoi Srei
thank
ou
you.
Nun. Him.
In general, in the implementation of the
Question.
CPK's policy at S21 at that time,
pour
the cadre at
du PCK S21 à l'époque,
what levels? For example, you yourself, you said you were the medium cadre. Was there any kind of measurement to determine whether cadres at S21 at any level who were entitled to attend meetings
et
with
leur droit Sun Sen ou de participer à une réunion avec Sun Sen
the standing
ou à une réunion
the center party,
du
committee.
Centre du parti.
The accused. The people who attended the annual meetings and study sessions with the center party were people who had the title of the assistant to the center party and above. And I was not yet appointed or entering that level. I was regarded as average or medium cadre. Nat was also medium cadre.
Appartenait au même échelon que moi.
Ian Thirud was also the medium cadre, but Chum Sam Auk, alias Pang, was the member of the center party. Mihmut Sumed were all members of the center party. So people who were medium cadres were those who were not yet appointed to the party centers. So the reason that I attended session with Son Sen, it was not because I was the member of the party center. According to Article 8, I was assigned to work under the immediate supervision of the Standing Committee. And at S21, it was I who was assigned to, according to that article. And when I was at the S21, when Nat was still the chairperson, we were invited both. And then at later date, the superior only asked me alone, and he did not ask Ho to attend any session with him. Mr. Kum Soon, thank you. I would like to go back a little bit to S21 matter. You said in several occasions already, however, I would like you to tell the court that, of course, I already understand that people who were sent to S21 were presumed dead. However, regarding the transferring of people from all locations to S21, you said that sometimes documents were attached, as you responded to the questions by the co-prosecutor, for example, in the case of the people who were sent from Thailand, who were sent along with documents. Do I understand correctly that some people were also sent along with the documents attached? The accused. Thank you, Mr. Kum Soon. I think when you talk about documents, it is rather broad. It is more about the list of the names. Because yesterday I saw my annotation on the list of the names. It was not about the document. So I think I cannot say that every person who was sent would be attached with the list of names. But after having seen such list, I can really work on a case-by-case basis. Mr. Kum Soon, thank you. Could you please clarify a little bit, according to the policy or the line of the CPK, the term enemies,
au pluriel.
In general, to your knowledge,
en général et à votre
how many categories the terms enemies were classified? I'm not basing on the document because I'm here talking about the enemies. For example, whether the enemies of the ideology, the internal enemies boring within the ranks or outside the ranks. So I'm talking about the enemies. So who were regarded as enemies?
Qui étaient considérés comme les ennemis?
The accused. I would like to reiterate that.
L'accusé, j'aimerais répéter.
The term ideological enemies were used long ago, but they did not kill enemies of that kind. It's only they were only educated to have a strong proletarian class. Then, after the epidemic in 1960s, Pol Pot raised this issue to fight the enemy, ideological enemies, and he wrote a song.
Et il a écrit une chanson.
about it. So the that term has been used long ago. However, the born within enemies had been found after the 17th of April, especially after the 30th of March 1976, so far as I remember. I think it is just my brief analysis, and I think we need further clarification on this matter at a later date. The class enemy, in relation to the economic regime or the political regime, they were obvious that the CPK smashed and evacuated them after the 17th of April. And at the same time, I would like to also share with you, Mr. Hong Kim-soon, that the CPK was not the Democratic Party of Cambodia. It was the government under this party. So the party was different from the government. So I would like you to be aware of the terms. I'm sorry to say that. Mr. Hong Kim-soon, thank you.
Maître Hong Kim-soon, je vous remercie.
You once again reiterated the struggle, the class struggle principle after the 17th of April 1975. You, in many occasions, said that Pol Pot changed his mind and derived from the previous principle before 1975. So the proletarian class struggle, or the class struggle, as you said, concerning the workers' class, the peasant class,
aux classes paysannes, aux classes des travailleurs.
Here, when people were arrested and sent from various sources to S21, they were regarded as the effort to attack the class enemies or not?
Les ennemis visant à attaquer les ennemis de classe ou pas?
The class enemies,
les ennemis de classe,
were determined in general,
and
internal or born within enemies were also regarded as the enemies, the class enemies. However, there were elements of the enemies within that term. They were still the class enemies, and it was based on the philosophy of the Communist Party theory at that time. Mr. Kim-soon, thank you.
Maître Kim-soon, je vous remercie.
I may ask another question to follow up what you said here, that at S21 there were two purposes. First, to interrogate the people who were sent for confessions, and also to make more arrests based on the implications found in the confessions. Do I understand you correctly?
The accused, that is correct.
L'accusé, Hong Kim-soon, thank you. Hong Kim-soon, je vous remercie.
So in leading the S21, or in the your role as the chairman of S21, the organization or the strategy management for interrogation, as you said, of those people who were regarded as prisoners, and the taking out of those people to be killed, to be killed around S21 or at the Bangkien 8, was it the principle of the killing of those people?
Quel était le principe derrière cette
the accused,
ces exécutions?
The method of killing of those people,
l'accusé.
I have repeatedly said about these two judges. Let me briefly state that
les méthodes
when the S21 was initially established, not ask me how people would kill at M13, and I responded that they were beaten and Nat was satisfied with the stabbing by the knife on the neck.
En les égorgeant.
So he ordered S21, the special unit of S21, to implement this method. And when the party ordered S21 to smash, Suhno Elistchuk and Nung Soon at 5 a.m. in the morning,
à 5 heures du matin,
I was ordered by the party to witness the killing.
Eh bien, moi, à 5 heures du matin,
by using the stepping method.
D'être le témoin.
And later on, I heard Comrade Hui, that is, Hum Hui, talking about the beating. So I believed there might be a shift in strategy.
Et d'après ce que j'ai vu, je me suis dit qu'il y avait un changement de stratégie.
However, in actual practice, there might be some modifications or changes.
Donc dans la pratique,
for those people which the party concerned that S21 might release, they must be killed and photographed as evidence.
Donc il a été instruit
so for those people who had to be photographed would be ordered by the party. For example, Comrade Pon at Srai Ambol. Another example, Von Vett and Chai Kum Ho, and Nat, former S21 chairman. So that is a strange strategy instructed by the party directly.
Aux exécutions de ces personnes-là, selon ces méthodes-là, les ordres venaient directement
du centre
du parti de l'échelon supérieur. Le président.
And also because the DVD recording is running out, the chamber will now take a break for 20 minutes, and we will resume at 11 a.m.
De 20 minutes et nous reprendrons les débats à 11 heures.